Maybe you could just comment on the comparison of this to C.S. Lewis's writings, or on the sorcerers, or the Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, that's an excellent question, because it does come up a lot. The big difference, I think, between these books and either Lewis's work or Tolkien, the Lord of the Rings type work, is that first of all, both Tolkien and C.S. Lewis were Christian, writing from a Christian perspective. C.S. Lewis's, I think, his credentials don't need mentioning. Tolkien was a very devout, very serious Roman Catholic. I mean, whatever you think of Catholicism, it's obvious that he had Judeo-Christian values, and they are embedded in these books. Additionally, to talk about The Lord of the Rings, because that's on everyone's mind since this big whopper of a movie just came out about a month after Harry Potter did, there are some problematic things in The Lord of the Rings. It is fantasy, of course, and it's not, you see, here's one thing to remember. It's not set in the real world. Harry Potter is a real kid in real 21st century London, you know, or wherever he lives. I mean, whereas The Lord of the Rings is set in this ancient time in Middle Earth that's thousands of years ago, but there are a couple of characters in the novels that are good wizards, and that, I think, is problematic. But on the other hand, the hero of the story of The Lord of the Rings is Frodo Baggins, who's a normal person. He is not he's a 4-foot-tall hobbit, you know, with furry feet, but I mean, he's not a magician of any
kind.
That's
not real normal, is it?
What I'm saying is he's not in any way a magician. He's entrusted with this magic ring. That's the thrust of the movie and of the books. And this ring is portrayed as an artifact of an ancient evil god, Sauron. And Sauron's ring, which is this ring of power, corrupts. And it's the movie very graphically shows how magic corrupts. And now even Gandalf, who's the good wizard,
which is a contradiction in terms.
Yeah, but he's kind of one of the heroes of the story. He won't touch this ring because he knows if he even touches it, it will corrupt him. And that's one of the points that Tolkien was trying to get across in his books, which has thankfully made it into the movie, is that magic corrupts. That, you know, we all have heard the statement, power corrupts. Well, magic is the ultimate source of power, and so he shows very clearly, and even in the movie, it shows that magic corrupts. Now, there's a lot of graphic violence in the movie. I don't think I would take a little kid to it in any way, shape, or form, and I'm not sure it's appropriate entertainment. But it is a masterful portrayal of how magic will corrupt you and how it can even demonize you. And so in that sense, it is a lot better. And of course, C.S. Lewis's books are Christian allegories. Now, yes, there are characters in them like witches and things, but it's intended to be an allegory that teaches strong Christian principles. So I think what we would say is C.S. Lewis's books, I mean, granted, there are some Christians that feel they're not good, you know, and that's a matter of some debate. But C.S. Lewis's books generally are fine. The Tolkien books are a guarded recommendation for adults, perhaps. And, of course, on the other hand, with Harry Potter, and I think one final important point, the hero of the Harry Potter books is a wizard, Harry Potter. And who do the readers identify with in a book? They identify with the hero. So all these thousands and millions of little kids that are reading this book, they're saying, I want to be just like Harry. You know, that's a big difference because the hero of these other books is not a wizard. And, you know, that's, I think, a huge difference.